Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. So lately I've been working on my IS300 for the air conditioning. My compressor went out and the condenser was basically dead, so I replaced both of those things. So on today's video, we're gonna go over how to recharge the system properly. We'll vacuum everything, we'll check, make sure there's no leaks, and then we'll fill it with R134A. So stay tuned. The recharge system, first thing you really need is a manifold set right here. I've got this Orion motoring brand one that I got on Amazon. It comes with all the hoses, all your connections, and a lot of the stuff you're gonna need to do this project. It did come with a black vacuum hose right here that fits right into this spot right here for the vacuum, but the problem was that the other side of the vacuum is a bigger size fitting that doesn't fit on the vacuum I borrowed from AutoZone. So I had to use this yellow one that I had. This is an extra one. It's actually a good brand refrigerant hose that I had that has the same connections on both sides. So that one actually screws into the vacuum properly. So here's what the rest of the kit comes with right here. It comes with a Schrader valve removal. It comes with a can adapter for the charging part. It's got this weird compression one that's like an older style can. I went ahead and just bought this one. It's also an Orion motoring brand that just screws in, that fits a lot better into the cans that you could buy today. And it comes with these separate fittings that can fit into various adapters and hoses. So the other end of the hose comes with the high side and the low side adapters for the red and blue hoses. It comes with a charge side that screws into your can adapter that I showed you a second ago. And then this one right here, which is supposed to be the black one, but I'm using yellow, goes into the vacuum. Up here, you have the on, off, and open, close valves for the vacuum, the refrigerant, and the high and the low side. So those you're gonna have to open up when you do the vacuum. So for this project, previously, I replaced the condenser right there. I replaced the compressor down there with a used one that I got from the junkyard. This one was pretty much brand new looking when I got it. And then I flushed the whole system. I've got separate videos for that if you guys wanna check those videos out where I'm doing all that. I replaced the expansion valve and I flush everything with a solvent-based flush. You can check out those videos for more details and instructions if you have to do that prior to this. So one thing that's very important is to make sure you have enough oil in your system, especially if you flush it or you get a new compressor or new components. If you have a Toyota or most cars, you'll have a sticker right here that shows you basically how much refrigerant you need and what type of oil you use. And then you gotta look up online or on the specs of the car to see how much oil you put in here. For the IS300 and most Toyotas, it uses about 3 ounces, 3.5 ounces of oil. You gotta make sure you put enough in the compressor and in the line before you start. For this particular vehicle, you can see it uses an R134A. And you got your max and minimum weight of the refrigerant right there. It's about 1.43 max and 1.21 minimum pounds. And then you got your kilos right there. So as far as adding oil goes, if you're replacing a major component like the compressor or the condenser, usually the manual tells you to fill about 1.4 ounces into the condenser, 1.4 into the evaporator. The overall system, like I said, uses about 3, 3.5. If you buy a new denso compressor, it comes with 3.9 already filled in just to do the whole system and just a little bit extra just in case. So if you end up doing that and you flush everything out, make sure you don't fill the rest of it in. For my particular case, I got that used. I drained everything out of the compressor. I put it in here and then I put the other half inside the compressor just to make sure I had the 3 ounces or 3.5 ounces of oil for that. In addition, if you don't end up putting it in those places, you can always fill up the oil straight into the fill line before you put the can on here, just to make sure you have the oil in the line and it gets sucked through the system once the refrigerant fills up. So we'll go ahead and vacuum the system. First thing you want to do is make sure you put your lines on the high and the low side. So you just unscrew the valves right here. Make sure if you are doing the system that you get new Schrader valves in here. Make sure everything's brand new and oiled up. Same with all the seals if you're replacing all your components. You want to put it on here, you want to turn this thing to open. That way it pushes the Schrader valve down. Same with the low side. You're gonna go ahead and reach down here for the low side. It's usually an L on the cap or a blue cap. You wanna go do the same here and then open it up, put that in there. For the vacuum side, you wanna just go ahead and screw that into the vacuum. Usually the vacuums have two ports. You wanna make sure the other port is closed and tight so you don't lose any vacuum there. And then on this side, before you start, you want to make sure the high and the low side are open. You want to close the refrigerant and then you want to open the vacuum. That way, once you turn on the vacuum, you can run it. Once you have the vacuum and everything plugged in, go ahead and just turn it on and run it for 30 minutes and watch the gauge go down. As you can see, with the vacuum on, it drops to negative 30 on both sides. Let this thing run for about 30 minutes to make sure there's no leaks. And then after you let it run for 30 minutes, you want to turn it off and let it sit with all these things closed. You want to close up all the valves and everything and let it sit and see if it loses any pressure or gains any pressure from vacuum. All right, we've let this thing run for a little bit over 30 minutes now. The pressure and everything or the vacuum is still holding. So what you want to do is just close the vacuum line right here and then shut off the vacuum. You want to leave the high and the low side open just because you want that gauge to read the vacuum and make sure you didn't lose any vacuum. So we'll go ahead and let this thing sit here for about 45 minutes to an hour just to make sure that everything's sealed up and we don't have any leaks. If you lose any kind of vacuum on either side, that means there's a leak somewhere. So you want to go ahead and just monitor that. Okay, we've let it sit for about 45 minutes, almost an hour now, and still in vacuum. Needles haven't moved, so I'll go ahead and vacuum this for another 45 minutes to an hour before we fill it with refrigerant. It's about an hour later. We'll go ahead and close up the vacuum. Then for this one, we'll go ahead and close up both sides too, just to make sure we seal up everything. Go ahead, push the car outside so we can fill up the refrigerant and start the car up. All right, so next thing we want to do is we go ahead, put the new valve on here onto the can, connect our refrigerant line here into the can. You can just hand tighten all this stuff just to make sure it doesn't over tighten and mess up the seal. The seals inside of each one of these basically seal it up for you, so you don't have to worry. So when we put it in here, we need to purge this thing. So there's a little purge valve right here on the bottom here. So we need to purge that. Even though once we open it up, it's gonna have refrigerant in it, there is also air in here. So you need to make sure you purge that line so you don't get any of the air into the system. So to start, we basically need to penetrate the can once, make sure this thing's tight and doesn't come loose. Hand tight. We're gonna just turn this thing down and you'll hear it. You hear it puncture the can and then you release it. Open the can a little bit. Let's the refrigerant in the line. So now you got the refrigerant in the line. You want to go ahead, take this valve off right here and just squeeze the valve just to purge the air a little bit. You'll see some of the refrigerant come out. There you go. Stay clear of it. So once you purged it, go ahead and close it up. And then we're gonna start the car up and just open the valves up to fill everything up. We wanna only fill from the low pressure side. So we're inside the car, we're gonna go ahead and start this baby up. You want the car running. And then you wanna turn your air conditioning on to the like a low setting. So probably around like 70 something degrees. Hit it on the low setting. And right now, the compressor's not gonna kick on because there's no pressure in it, but we need it to run and we're gonna go ahead and fill the refrigerant from the low side. We wanna go ahead and open the valve for the refrigerant. And then we wanna open the low side. Make sure we move this thing. You can see it's going to slowly charge and you can kind of move this thing around just to make sure. Slowly. All right, right there, that was the refrigerant kicking in. And you can look at the sight glass right here and you can see the refrigerant moving. So you just want to let it sit here for a couple minutes just to make sure it discharges. If we let it sit here for a couple minutes just to make sure, you want to just shake the can up, turn it around, make sure there's nothing right here filling the can. So none of the refrigerant is flowing anymore. So we just close this one off, and then we're gonna go ahead and change the can to the next one. The next one we're gonna have to measure, just because we don't wanna put the full can in. We only need 22 ounces, almost 23 ounces. This is 24 with the two 12 ounce bottles, so we're not gonna use it fully. So we put this thing on the scale. Right now it's at 21, or a little bit more than 21 ounces. So what we're gonna go ahead and do, take it down to 11 ounces and then close off the valve. So again, what we need to do is just purge the line since we connected up the new bottle. All right, so we got refrigerant in there. So we'll go ahead and put the valve back on. We're at 20.5 right now after I purged it. So what you're gonna do is slowly release this and let it just, that it doesn't, it's not a liquid. You wanna make sure it's a gas going in, right? So we just let it slowly fill. Once we get down to about 10, we'll shut it off. All right, we finally let it go down to about 9.5 there. Go ahead and close all these off. Make sure everything's tight. Here's our operating pressures right now, which is good because we got about 30 PSI over here, maybe 25, 30 PSI, and then almost 200 on this side, which is working properly. Then inside, I've just got this regular freezer gauge. I don't have one of those ones that is nice that sticks into the vent, but I'm getting about a little under 50 degrees discharge, which is nice and cool. With the engine off and everything steady state, this looks right. Looks like we have about 80 on the low side, and then we're dropping about 120 on the high side, so that looks good. If you take everything off, make sure you close up this side by doing this for the Schrader valve, so that way it's not pushing the Schrader valve. And then we want to do the same over here. Just go ahead and unscrew that, and then once you pop it, it's probably going to release a little bit of air. But right now everything's sealed in those hoses. Everything looks good here, and the pressure is gonna stay there because all these things are locked. So just to confirm how much we use, we'll look at the empty can right here, the tear weight of that empty can. It's about 3.3 ounces. And then we'll put the can that still has a little bit of refrigerant and the valve on top. And this one's at about almost 8, so minus 3.3, that leaves you 4. Figure like an ounce for that thing, an ounce and a half. So that's around 2 or 3 ounces left in this bottle. You could hear it. So we discharged just enough in the system to work properly. Hey guys, thanks for joining me all the way to the end of this quick video on showing you how to recharge that air conditioning. As you can see, if you follow all the steps and you have all the right tools, it shouldn't take you more than 15, 20 minutes just to get everything done. The hardest part is doing all the vacuuming and making sure you have an airtight system and a nice and dry system. If you guys found this video useful, give it a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed to my channel to stay on top of all my different DIY videos, go ahead and subscribe to your channel. Turn on bell notifications to get notified every time I upload a video. For all these different projects, if I can do it, you guys can do it. I want to thank you for watching, and I'll talk to you guys next time.